way, Hushpuppi's fraudulent activities and arrest without a doubt have labeled him the biggest fraudster of the year. After the stories of his arrest and billions of dollar fraud activities went viral and was covered by numerous media platforms, both small and big across the globe, it wasn't a surprise when he hired criminal defense attorney Gal Pissetzky to defend him. The Chicago-based criminal defense attorney, who has been involved in many notable cases in the United States, said his client is not guilty. He sprang into action after reaching an agreement with Hushpuppi and has swiftly come out to claim that 37-year-old Ramon Olorunwa Abbas, aka Hushpuppi, runs a legitimate business as an entrepreneur and is not guilty of fraud and money laundering as claimed. He told the BBC that the FBI kidnapped his client from Dubai and took him to America. Gal Pissetzky also spoke to the Punch newspaper Nigeria and said he planned to put vigorous defense to get Hushpuppi out of the case. So we ask, can he set a man charged of billions of dollars of fraud with the 26 pages of court transcript detailing his fraudulent activities free?
Hello guys, it's Nolan here from African Glitz.
Pissetzky has stepped forward as Hushpuppi's defense attorney, and after his first interview with Forbes, where he insisted that his client Ramon Abbas is an entrepreneur who made his money legitimately through real estate and his hard work promoting brands as an Instagram personality where he has at least 2.5 million followers. He also spoke to the BBC and accused the FBI of kidnapping his client from Dubai and took him to the US. He also claimed that the United Arab Emirates has no extradition treaty with the United States. He added that Hushpuppi is not a criminal and has made all his money legitimately. He also said if Dubai wanted to expel Hushpuppi, they should have expelled him back to Nigeria. This comes after the FBI published a 26-page affidavit on the 25th of June 2020, listing in detail several of Hushpuppi's fraud attempts to huge companies. They alleged that the suspected Dubai-based fraudster conspired to launder funds stolen from a 14.7 million cyber heist from a foreign financial institution, matched that of the attack on a Malta's Bank of Valletta in February of 2019. He was also accused of being involved in a fraudulent scheme which defrauded a New York-based law firm of almost $1 million through a combination of computer hacking and social engineering, and another £100 million fraudulent attempt with an English Premier League Football Club. Gal Pissetzky was asked if he could consider a plea bargain with the system to reduce Abbas' sentence. He said this is a discussion between him and his client. Hushpuppi, who is currently being held at the MCC Chicago, pending a bail hearing, faces a statutory maximum sentence of 20 years in federal prison. A hearing in Chicago on Monday, July 13th, will determine if Abbas will be detained pending trial. Hushpuppi and 11 members of his gang were arrested while sleeping at their Dubai residence. Their arrest in Operation Codenamed Fox Hunt 2 came after 4 months of investigation into their activities, during which their social media accounts were monitored by highly trained police units. In the video that went viral within minutes, the Dubai police claimed that the gang was responsible for a $1.6 billion deal fraud involving close to 2 million victims. Items worth millions were also seized on the night. The Dubai police later handed Hushpuppi to the Federal Bureau of Investigation in the US, where he was rearranged on charges of conspiracy to commit money laundering and other frauds. Hushpuppi's shocking arrest is also affecting Nigerians. Employers in Dubai are rejecting Nigerian job applicants. Also, job applications are appearing online where applicants from Nigeria have been singled out. Some Nigerians are being refused visas. At the same time, some websites have blocked Nigerians from accessing their website or businesses. Hushpuppi and his gang's arrest has also shocked Nigeria's anti-graft agency, Economic and Financial Crime Commission EFCC, like EQUIC, and resulted in East Chairman Ibrahim Magu being suspended and interrogated for crimes and his connection with Hushpuppi. Talk about the hunter being hunted. We will definitely be sharing this story in one of our upcoming videos, as well as some other interesting videos about crime. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel, do so now so that you'll be notified once we drop these videos. Do you think Hushpuppi may likely be granted bail with a good defense lawyer? If his attorney claims that he has a legitimate business, does that mean he pays tax? Share your thoughts with us on the comment section down below.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to check out our channel for other trending African stories and news. Thanks for watching and see you on our next one.